I'm gonna show you a personal branding positioning strategy done very wrong, something that you definitely want to avoid and not make this mistake. So stick around, we're getting started right now. Yo, what is up? Zachary Babcock here, former drug addict, spent over 5 years of my life in prison, turned underdog entrepreneur, and a prove 'em wrong prodigy, top 200 iTunes podcast host. What is up? Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, and if you want the best tips on how to turbocharge your lead generation and customer acquisition, make sure you hit the subscribe button and tap the bell notifications. That way you don't miss anything. With that out the way, yo, I'm getting ready to share with you a key personal branding positioning strategy that you want to avoid at all costs. And before we get started with this, if you know anybody building a personal brand, got any friends out there on your social media, share this video out. They need to see this too. Trust me. All right, so with that all being said, let's dive right into the slide deck. Let me show you how to avoid this key major mistake.
The worst, maybe not the worst, but one of a really bad positioning, personal branding positioning tactic is acting like a lottery winner when something happens. What I mean by that, so don't make everything a big deal on your come up in a this doesn't happen to me much type of way, or I'm surprised myself kind of way. And what I mean by that, if you get a client, or don't celebrate like you won the lottery. And the same with traveling somewhere. You know, somebody like, oh my God, we're going to Bora Bora, like it never happens to you, and it comes off. The vibe you want to go for is, of course this is happening. Like, you know, this is who I am. This is just a regular occurrence to me. This isn't like, oh my God, I can't believe this is happening. You know, because if you are overly excited at stuff, it projects to yourself and the world that this is a rare occurrence, and you'll attract less of it. And it also makes your position look weak. So here's an example. This guy got featured on Entrepreneur Magazine. And you see, he got the little surprise face. I got featured on Entrepreneur Magazine. And it's like, exclamation point. Honored to be a part of this. You guys are the real deal. Huge players in the video. Make sure to check it out. And it's like, oh my God, he just won the lottery. Like, he can't believe it happened. Now, I know Mitch, one of my close friends, got featured in the same article. And look at how different his post is. A little entrepreneurial inspiration for you today from entrepreneur.com. No exclamation points, no emojis. A sincere thank you from Influencer Press for being nice enough to include me with all these super hustlers. You see, it's like a natural occurrence. Like he's grateful that it happened, but it isn't like, oh my God, I just won the lottery. See the difference here? It's not like, oh my God, this doesn't happen to me often. It's like, no, this is pretty cool. You know, got featured in the day with some pretty cool peeps. So that's the vibe you're aiming for. Don't come off as the lottery winner. It makes you look weak as heck, and it's going to kill your personal branding positioning.
All right, was that helpful? Did that give you, was that something that you already knew, or was it something new to you? Let me know if you already knew about this and that you don't want to, you know, be like a lottery winner. And if this is something new to you and maybe that you've been doing, you don't have to say if you've been doing or not, whatever, I don't care. But if it was something new to you that you didn't know about, let me know in the comments below. Give me a thumbs up if this video was awesome, if it helped you add value. And if it sucked, hit it with a thumbs down. I definitely would love your honest, sincere, appreciative feedback. It would be great. Greatly appreciate it, so I know how to get better in the future. If you haven't already subscribed to this channel, hit the subscribe button and tap the bell notifications if you want the best tips on lead generation and customer acquisition. And I will see you on the next video, my friend. But until then, you can check out one of these videos I'm getting ready to share with you right now.
We put them hours in to bring them dollars in. It's that underdog empowerment. We put them hours in to bring them.